Up the Skull, Up the Skull out here at Catholic Central, and I'm here with a great, you know what I'm saying, with a great. He's younger than me, but don't let the age fool you, man. My man probably still got it, man.
Man, I don't got nothing left, nothing left.
You got that.
And great is a very usually used term.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, listen, man, go ahead and introduce it to the people that don't know who you are. You know, like I know who you are, but you know, let everybody know who you are.
Devin Gardner, former quarterback at the University of Michigan.
That's not all your accolades, though, but we're going to leave it at that.
He don't need to do all of that.
You know, no New England, no, you know what I'm saying?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? None of that great stuff, man. So talk a little bit about what you do, you know, before these kids. And then you, I know you have an academy. You know, you train kids often. You know, I've seen you around in the Legacy Center, you know what I'm saying, giving kids great pointers, great mentor, man. Just talk a little bit about what you do.
Yeah, I mean, I've gotten a lot of football knowledge, and one thing that football has done for me is, you know, made me a better man, you know what I mean? So as much as I can try to impart some of the wisdom that I've gotten to the other kids, I mean, that's the purpose, right? That's the purpose. That's the reason I'm here. So I just try to do it as much as possible, and not as many kids as possible, though, you know, because you got to be a special kind of kid to make sure that you, you know, but I try to get as many kids as I can to make sure that they kind of go in the right direction and use football as a tool rather than a lot of people are letting football use them, which you don't get anything out of it. So
right. So what do you tell those families and that one young man? And now we have young legends that actually play the game of football now. So what do you tell those kids? Those are the best. I ain't gonna lie. I love watching them.
Yeah.
So give them something, you know, to inspire them. Like tell them something that you wish you would have known back when they was their age.
I did know this when I was their age, and I just don't think it's enough people that understand this, but believing in yourself, and you know, a lot of people walk around acting like they believe in themselves, but they don't truly believe in yourself. I'm talking about, like, no matter who's in the room, right? Like, my favorite quarterback is Michael Vick. As a 10-year-old, if I walked in the room with Michael Vick, I thought I was the best quarterback there, right? Or the best player there, you know? And it's not as much arrogance as it is confidence, just because you work so hard, right? So if you don't work so hard and you walk in every room thinking you like that and you think you're the guy, then, or the girl in this case, then now you're a little arrogant, right? But you know how much work you put in, and the one person you can't lie to is yourself, right? So you can walk around with your chest all out like you're working hard and post on the internet after 2 minutes of work and whatever.
The championship game.
At some point, the real will show, and you can't lie to yourself. And so when you walk across and you see another dog, right? Because a lot of times it's not a lot of dogs out here, right? So if you're a dog, you're good to go, right? Because there ain't no other dogs. But you come across that other dog that is doing the work and it is working hard, that's when the not being able to lie to yourself comes in the play.
Touchdown.
And you're gonna crumble, you're gonna fail, right? And so to avoid that, I mean, first work as hard as you possibly can. You never know what somebody is doing in Texas or in Hawaii or wherever the case may be. Work as hard as you can and build that real confidence, and once you have that, I believe you're unstoppable. Like, I've been unstoppable my whole life just because I've worked so hard and you know, put it all in the work. And so if you work hard, you will be unstoppable.
Be unstoppable. Believe in yourself. And my favorite thing is the 3 F's: faith, focus, finish.
100%.
You know what I'm saying? If you have that faith, you know what I'm saying, you're gonna be able to focus on what you need to finish.
A lot of people talk about, you know, belief.
There you go.
I don't press my beliefs on other
for
people.
Sure.
As far as hard work, that's a belief. But God and all those different things.
Yeah.
But I believe you have to believe in something.
Got
right?
To.
It's hard to get through life, which is so hard, right? And then for kids, they don't understand just yet, but football teaches you how to deal with all the things you're going to deal with in real life. And so if you can fight and get through life, you're going to have some kind of belief to do that. And so if you don't have faith in something, it's going to be tough for you. And if you get through it, more power to you, because I can't do it without the faith. Yeah.
At least have faith in yourself, man. That sounds like the moral of the story here, man. Yeah. So I appreciate you taking the time out, you know, as we watch this beautiful game that we love so much, football.
Yeah.
And, you know, let's continue up the skull, man.
Let's keep up in the skull. I like that. Up the skull. Because everybody went up the skull.
Everybody went up the skull, but you can't believe in yourself to up the skull.
You can't up the skull without believing in yourself.
Yeah, that might be our new motto, baby. Up the skull if you can't believe in yourself, baby. And we out, man. Indeed.